just finish up a few things here. And then we finna about to talk to y'all.
Something in the water. Something about the whispers. Hey, oh, hey, oh. You can't imagine the way that this cash feeling.
We are now in the tail end of 1 year into this COVID-19 pandemic. Man, so many things has happened. Drastic things. Traumatic things. I guess I should start by saying, I've been a YouTube member for quite some time now. And I had a different perspective with YouTube at the time. I have family across seas. I'm from California. Represent the Dubs. Represent the Niners. Niner gang, man. Represent. Anyway. I had loved ones from across seas. And the only way that I am able to share some of my life moments with my kids and family, just in general, birthday parties or something funny or something like that. I would upload videos on YouTube and create a video and send them the link. You know, that's kind of how I was communicating and being able to share some life experiences with my family members. And social media, which I don't have one, just blew up, and YouTube blew up with it. And if you guys been following me, I'm kind of up and down with the video uploads, mainly because life, just running out of time, or having time, or basically what I'm saying is this is all just a hobby for me. I'm not here intending to make money or a career out of, what do they call it, vlogging. Making money, sure, that'd be great. Extra change, great, man. But my passion is just, being a voice, hopefully. I'm nearing my 40s now, and I never, thought that the world would enjoy criticizing every single person in the world by the use of the internet. Man, just boomed. So a little bit about myself. I was born in the 80s. I'm an 80s baby. And I used to always carry a video camera in my hand, man. 6 years old, 7 years old, family parties, I came to America when I was 5, 6. So, being in America, California, for almost, or damn near basically 35 years, life's been good, I'm a suburban kid. I grew up in San Francisco, Daly City, whatever you want to call it, and life was good, man. Life is still good, I'm still living in the Bay Area, a little bit on the outskirts, but I came here to talk about 2020, a year into COVID, a year into the passing of Kobe Bean Bryant. And what I've realized during this pandemic, the top three things I've realized and learned from this pandemic. Number one, health. Health has become the most important thing you can possibly do for yourself right now. Think about it. If you're not healthy, you're in danger. If you have health issues, either because you're not healthy, or you just have health issues in general. Pandemic is going to hit you hard. And elderly, you know, God forbid that, you know, that our elderly, our most knowledgeable people in the world, we lose. It's tragic. And so, because the workout facilities are closed, I mean, at least in California, and, you know, in the ATL or in Florida, Texas, you know, they partying it up, man. No mask, no nothing. I just saw a concert by a favorite rapper of mine, Easy, show up at a club and party it up and perform. I think this was just a couple days ago, actually over the weekend. And so, you know, California is different. It's, you live here, you understand. But being from California, we don't see, unless you specifically, you know, dig it up on the internet, it's not broadcast in the media that the other states are as open and as free as if COVID, the COVID-19 ever existed. Anyway, going back to the number one reason, health. Here, workout facilities, fitness facilities have closed down, and I've always had like a miniature gym in my garage, but this past year, full blown. You know, first things first is get rid of the things I didn't need, make shelves in the garage so I can start stacking stuff up high and have floor space that I need to create a gym atmosphere. That's been great. That's been working out. I always focus on, you know, buying workout equipment that is mobile, that I can move around, because at the end of the day, you know, I still got cars that I need to park inside the garage. So every morning I drive the two cars out of the garage. I got a two-car garage, and I set up, and not particularly working out every day, but setting it up to, the main thing, motivate me to go work out. And that's important. You know, if I see my workout equipment all set up and I'm working throughout the day, and if I take a break from work and I go out to the garage, then it's there, you know, and it's attracting to me. And does it work every day? No, of course not, man. I'm human. I'm not gonna fake it with y'all. I might work out 2, 3, 4 times a week. That's including weekends. From punching bag to core workouts to a bench, some padded floor so I can do push-ups. I hooked up the TRX. I got 4 TRX bands hanging from the ceiling. I got a cycle bike. I got a small little treadmill that can kind of, everyone makes fun of it because it's so small that, you know, you'll lose balance and fall right off of it. But I don't need a full-blown treadmill in my garage, mainly because, one, it's hard to move, and two, I don't need to be running fucking 3, 4, 5 miles, but 10 miles a day. I can do that outside. I just need something to work, to get me started, to get me sweating, so I can do all the other workouts. I also have a hyperextension bench. I have an inverter bench. I think that's pretty much it. I have a Bosu ball, if that's how you pronounce it. But I don't have much. But all these equipment, I am able to fold and put away so I can utilize my garage the traditional way. So health. Health is the most important thing. Two, I have kids. Education. That is a heartbreaker for me. You know, was education important to me when I was younger? No, Was I good in school? Yeah, I'd say so. I never failed. I graduated on time. By the time I was senior year, I had two classes, both electives, then I went to work. School was easy. But I didn't see school then, and I don't see school now the way most people see school. I saw school as a social life, a way to grow. Was I popular? No, but I had a ton of friends. You know, school helped me meet the most spectacular people that I've ever met. And I mean, do I know celebrities? No, just I know normal guys. And you know, I have a handful of best friends, have a gang full of acquaintances, but each person that I have met, that I've come in contact with, has molded me into the kind of person I am today. And so school, in that sense, is very important. Well, now, you know, my kids are going to school online. They can literally go through the day, online school, without paying attention. And where I live, school's top notch. You know, the teachers pay attention at the students. Hey, you know, keep your head up. Hey, I just called you. What are you doing? Put your stuff away. So with the school program in my community is excellent, but I can only imagine the other schools that don't get that same attention. So, you know, I feel like this year is a wash when it comes to the school system. Are the kids learning? Honestly, no. They're probably given these handbook materials to do on their own. Teachers explains it really quick and then lets them out of class, right? And they're off and running. It hasn't hit them because they're living it right now, but school will definitely play a huge impact on their growth. The third most important thing that I've come to realize during this pandemic is the ability to understand. You know, I'm a family man. I got a day job. I got your normal 9-to-5, but I am also a basketball coach. I have had boys, kids that I train, and my son being one of my students, I miss seeing them doing that. You know, there's a few times where I actually forced it and invited, you know, kids to come and just play ball, you know. But transitioning into everyday social life, into having a social life in the internet, like playing video games, we all, as children from the 80s, the 90s, even early 2000s, we have to now understand that our children, our next generation, their social life is in the video games, is in the internet, FaceTime, Instagram, PS5 internet, Xbox internet, all of that. They're all talking and socializing with their friends. Some their best friends. Some people who they just met that day. They're socializing on the internet. And as parents, we have to understand that that is just a part of their life. Do we agree? No. I mean, that's normal. That's normal for parents to not agree to how their kids are getting brought up, but the reality is they're growing up as internet kids. So understand, accept. Do you have the mentality to say, no, I don't want you doing that. I don't want you playing video games. Well, you're taking one big thing out of your children is the ability to socialize and compartmentalize their social life. And so I don't agree not being able to adapt to that. Gotta understand that that's part of their life, but don't limit them to that. They can do more, right? Again, out of state, this is probably not a huge effect, but in California, you know, you get hypersensitive parents who don't want their kids having any contact with any other kids, but you have ones that don't. So if they don't have that physical activity or that social life outside your home and outside the internet, then they don't have it at all. Embrace the different perspective and not disable your children from having a social life on the internet. Adapt to it, challenge the kids to do more. I'm not even a therapist. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Sports. Wow. Curry's coming off of his injury. I believe it's the wrist injury. Klay Thompson is gone for the second year in a row to an ACL injury. My Warriors, man, they're not struggling at like in the 90s, early 2000s. They're a mediocre team right now, but Curry is, man, he is balling. Like, I'm not amazed at his shooting. I'm not. There's, you know, again, I'm an 80s baby. In the 90s, I grew up loving the Bulls. I mean, who doesn't? Michael Jordan. But man, Larry Bird, Craig Hodges, Reggie Miller, you got Ray Allen in the early 2000s. Y'all have some shooters, you know what I'm saying? So I'm not, in that aspect, I'm not impressed by Steph's shooting. What I'm impressed about is his consistency of taking these so-called bad shots and making them. Average Joe, average NBA player, average college player, average high school player, average AAU player. These are bad shots that Curry is taking. They're bad shots. But Curry is so good at these bad shots that he's making these bad shots consistently, on a consistent basis. That is what that is amazing to me. What else is in sports? Kobe, rest in paradise, man. Can't stop thinking about that. Wasn't a Kobe fan because I had Jordan, you know, but, you know, never take away the appreciation of what Kobe was on the basketball court. Boy's a beast. He was a beast. LeBron James, just like how everyone is kind of taking LeBron James for granted right now. You know, I haven't been a LeBron fan. Again, because I had Jordan, right? But I can appreciate his level of consistency. He's been in his prime for like 10 years, or shit, ever since he was in the league, he was in his prime. But he is so underappreciated as a all-time great. But you know where that GOAT conversation goes to. Don't go it with me. Life. I was upset with my family during the holidays. You know, my family and I, coming from eight kids, or being the eighth child, I love my family. I always want to get together with my family. And when the pandemic hit, we almost kind of came to this conclusion that we would only see each other one Sunday a month, and have our mask on, make sure, you know, my mom is older, and so everyone was really focused on their concerns with her, mine too. But I was upset because though we are seeing each other every Sunday, one Sunday a month, my mom and the rest of the family agreed to not spend Christmas Eve together, which by far for me growing up or me is the most important day to the Filipino culture as far as I'm concerned. How many Sundays is that? I don't know, approximately 12 Sundays, right, a year. I would have agreed not to see you guys, period, as long as I got to see you guys Christmas Eve. You know, that was very upsetting. That disappointed me. Rest in peace to my dad. He would have been upset not being able to spend Christmas Eve and enjoy the food and enjoy the conversations and enjoy all the different generations getting together for one night and just celebrating life. That would have made him upset, and that's what made me upset. But I understood, because what? Someone might see a party going on at my mom's house and report us to the authorities, and then we would have gotten in trouble. Mom would have been pissed. I got that. But it doesn't take away the fact that I was upset. What even made me more upset was knowing that outside of California, everybody's just living life the way they're normally living, you know. And you can look it up all you want. I don't have to look it up. I mean, I know that there are places, more liberal places in the United States, that COVID doesn't even exist. And when I say don't even exist, don't even exist. Look it up. I think I'm done with my rambling. Been rambling a little too long. Enjoyed a video. Again, I don't have any social media. I have YouTube. Send some comments, questions, concern. And just 1 year into COVID, and here we are.